guys, welcome back. It's Lena Lucia. As you can hear from my voice, I am was sick. I have been sick for the last 2 weeks. I'm actually pretty glad that I pre-filmed the latest video that you saw from me because I was dead the last 2 weeks and now my voice is still a bit cracky. So I'm trying to do a really chill video and I figured I might do a natural makeup look because, I don't know, I think that's like the easiest thing to do when you're sick because you don't have to talk that much. And I really enjoy doing makeup, but I don't ever do it. Like literally the last time I put on makeup was when I filmed that Valentine's Day makeup thing. I'm really excited to put some makeup on to show you guys what a natural look is for me. Let's get right into it, I'd say. First up, I'm gonna take all of my hair away from my face because I cannot deal with that when I'm doing my makeup. Cool. Okay, so let's bring you in a bit closer. As you can see, I have two little friends here that are not really all that friendly. We're gonna cover these up and I just have some utensils in front of me. I'm trying to not talk as much because, as I said, like my voice is still cracky. First, I'm going in with this BB fresh cream, and this has been, so all of the stuff that I use is pretty old because like I bought it when I was 14 and then I have been using it since. So I'm gonna put some on the back of my hand just like that, and I'm gonna treat this as like foundation because I don't own a foundation. I've never worn foundation and I probably never will. And actually, fun fact, I don't have a mirror in front of myself, so this is gonna be my mirror. So in case I am constantly looking into this, no wonder why. So let's just pack this on and see if this helps in any way, shape or form. So I guess this did a little bit of something something to give me a bit of a more even complexion. Fortunately, I only have concealer here that's like a bit too dark for putting it under my eyes and under blemishes. But we're gonna see if we can make this work. See, these are the essentials that you need. Like what I have in my cosmetic drawer with along with all of my lotions and stuff is sex wax. That's the real shit. That's what you should have in your stuff. Oh yeah, and most of the brushes that I'm using are from Real Techniques. We are nice and blended and I have not worn that much makeup in a long time. Let's just take some of this like highlight powder thingy to just set it in place and maybe try to lighten it a bit. I just thought that it was unnecessary to do your brows, but apparently it's a really, really big part of doing your makeup. I still feel like every time I do them, they look a bit exaggerated. Like, look at this. Isn't this crazy? Yeah, we're just gonna line the brows very, very lightly. All that I use is some brow gel, and I got this gifted. This is the Benefit Gimme Brow, but this is completely empty. As I said, I don't do makeup anymore, so I don't buy new stuff, but let's just see if this does anything at all. And now for the eyes. I obviously don't want to put too much attention to the eyes because, as I said, this is like a natural makeup, so I'm just gonna take my bronzer, which this is the Hoola Benefit bronzer, and I just got a couple of different brushes that are like more buffy, more pointy, more dense, more chill, and I'm just gonna work a bit in into the crease and just try to give it like a natural depth kind of thing. So I'm just gonna take a tiny dot of this High Benefit High Beam. I'm just starting off with a little bit more of a denser brush, and all that I'm doing is basically pressing the pigment onto the outer edge of the eye. Again, the key here is to not overdo it with your first few stems, but to just put a little bit of color onto it and then work your way up, because we obviously don't want anything being too harsh since this is a natural makeup look, as I said a million times before. And now I'm just taking a bit of a fluffier brush, and then with nothing at all, I'm just buffing this out so that there are no harsh lines. And this is actually all that I'm gonna do to the eyes pigment wise. I'm still gonna put some mascara on, but this is it. And as you can see, like, I literally took three brushes in one single color. It took me 2 seconds and there's like so much more definition going on already, and it still looks natural because it's all matte and it's nothing like glittery or shimmery, so you can really tell that, oh yeah, this is definitely makeup. So here we are, done with the eyes, and what I want to do now is, I've never done that before, is to put on some fake freckles, because I actually do have some freckles. I feel like if I'm in the sun they pop a lot more, and there has not been a lot of sun around. I'm just gonna take my brow pencil. You want to do that before the bronzer so that way it blends in nicer and it looks a lot more natural. Okay, so as I said, this looks a bit harder, so you're just gonna take your foundation brush and kind of push them into the skin. Now let's get onto the real fun stuff, the bronzing. And this has been my favorite part by far ever since I started doing my makeup, and every time I do my makeup, because I just absolutely love it. So as I said, I'm gonna take my Hoola bronzer and I'm gonna put this on, and I'm just trying to not pack it on like crazy, but I'm gonna put some on, if you know what I mean. And what I always do is, I don't really try to like contour anything. I actually just want to bronze up my face. So instead of going like that and trying to carve out my face, I'm actually more of like going over my nose, because I really like that sunburned, sun-kissed kind of look that I have when I've been out in the sun like all day. It's all for the contour. So now we're gonna go in with blush, and I'm using the Essence Satin Touch blush. So we're just gonna put this on, as I said, like right under my eyes and on my cheeks and also heavily on the nose. And I just buff all of that out so we have no harsh lines going on. This is the part where you would use some setting spray. I have never owned setting spray before, but it's like water bottles that just disperse water, and I would use that right now, but I actually don't have them with me right now, so we're just gonna leave that and pretend that I do this nice shh, and then it's nice and molten into my face. So I am taking this high beam highlight again. Now I'm just taking my highlighter brush and I'm trying to, oh, this looks real nice, wow. I'm just trying to buff this out a bit more because, as I said before, like, the point of having natural makeup is to just have everything be as buffed as you possibly can, so nobody really notices that you have like a ton of makeup on. So for mascara, I again am just using something that I pulled out of my makeup baggie. So this is just a small package of the Real mascara, and I'm gonna need to be real quiet to do that so I don't mess it up, so I will see guys in a second. Every time I'm so shook by what a difference it makes to put on some mascara. Like, look at this. This is insane. So let's pray that the other side is just as good. Ta-da! This is what it looks like with mascara on, and every time I put it on, I just feel like it ties everything together no matter what you do. And then I'm gonna take some lip liner actually to put some of that onto my lips. And this is the Barbour Maxi Deficient Lip Liner Crayon Couture. I have no idea. This again, I basically found somewhere, but this looks like a nice color, so we're just gonna put this on. It looks pretty natural, and see how it goes. I'm trying to kind of give myself a bit more of a pout and hope that I don't look like Kylie Jenner. Wow, I love this. It's a bit dark, so maybe I have this Baby Lips lip gloss hydrating thing from Maybelline that's like a natural kind of nude color. So let me put some of that on top and maybe it's gonna be the perfect match. So yeah, this is all that I have for you guys. I hope that you really enjoyed this natural makeup look with me, and let me know if you want to see some more makeup looks, or if you guys don't like them at all, what you think of them, because I like doing a makeup look every once in a while because I enjoy makeup. This is what brought me to YouTube, actually, was watching tons of makeup tutorials, even though I don't use any makeup ever. So yeah, I really like how this turned out. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will technically see you guys again when I am 21. So yeah, bye. Fill the room with smoke, said pour another glass for me. Take out the games, baby, we both know. Today we are, I think I'm gonna lose this because this does not really look that cute. Down the neck to just blend it a bit. This is like auto-tune. What the fuck is... You definitely can tell that I'm still sick. Like, there's definitely something going on that I have no control over.